This is a buckwheat crêpe cooking on my stove on a Sunday, and this is a typical Sunday dinner in my French family. My mother-in-law is Breton, and you can see it's very lacy around the edges. There are all these little bubbles, and what I've got going here is I've got the oven on just the warm mode. And you can make the batter for this about 2 hours in advance. And you can make the galettes, well, really up to a day in advance. It's not a big problem. I'm just making them a few hours in advance, and they're going to sit in a warm oven. Now, the best thing to use in the pan, and this is a nonstick pan, which is very unhealthy, and I shouldn't be using it. The traditional pan is called a billig, and it's a three-legged cast iron thing that sits right in the fireplace. And it is kept lubricated with lard and egg yolk used in a rag. And I don't have any lard or duck fat or goose fat today, so I'm just using some butter. And this pan is well cured. I don't think I need to add any more butter. I'm going to put 4 spoonfuls of it here. And I'm going to tilt the pan and spread it around some and let it cook down pretty well. Now, there are some other videos up on YouTube which show the proper way to do this, which is a flat griddle and you smooth it down with this wooden thing. And I just don't have that equipment, so I'm not doing that. Now, see, this is very pretty. It should be lacy. I'm gluten intolerant, so regular crepes, which actually most of the French don't even eat, really don't agree with me. Now, to make this recipe, I learned this from the French Farmhouse Cookbook by Susan Hermann Loomis, and her buckwheat crêpes recipe is very easy, and it's 1.5 cups plus 1 tablespoon of buckwheat flour, 2¼ cups of water, 2 large eggs, 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt, and 1 tablespoon of clarified butter. So you just put the flour in a bowl and whisk in the water and then the egg and then the salt for a few minutes. The batter should be quite thin but elastic. When you lift the whisk, the batter will drop off in ropes. You can let it sit for up to 2 hours loosely covered, and if it sits, use the whisk again to, you know, to stir this stuff up again. And the way we eat this here in the family is just with a couple of eggs sunnyside on top. You know, I think that the stuff of putting a lot of cheese or ham on it and stuff, I really don't see that much here in France, but I have eaten in some crêperies where they offer sweet and savory crêpe and galette. This one tore a little bit. I'm going at it too quickly because I'm talking to you. You have to let them cook down some, and they should get brown around the edges. If you screw up and tear it, you can add a little bit more here like this and kind of patch up the holes. But this is just a family meal, so we really don't care. And I store these in the oven. And if you make them the day before, you just put them on a plate and cover them with one of those plate lids or something, and they will reheat just fine. You can just reheat them in a warm oven. And it's nice for the cook on Sunday nights, and it's very, very light, very digestible. I'm a little bit distracted. I hope you can understand me. In this particular pan, I can't flip them. But in fact, buckwheat crêpes might not even be flipped. It depends. You know, they might get a little bit too dry for the taste of the cook if that happens. But the thing that I like about this is that I find that it's best if I make this mix a couple of hours in advance and let it sit at room temperature covered with a warm tea towel. And it's early yet for dinner. We eat dinner at 7 generally in France, And these will be ready in a warm oven when I want them. And if there are too many left over, there'll be more for tomorrow. See? See how pretty that is? See all the little bubbles and everything? This one's a little bit messed up because I was distracted talking to you. But the other ones have come out really well. And really, I have tried goose fat with egg yolk as the grease in the pan for these in the past. And it really does work better than butter. So that's not just craziness. I can't imagine why it's better, but it just is. All right, see you later.